For American Family News, I'm Robert Thornton. Residents in Florida are making last-minute preparations ahead of a major storm. Fox Weather's Brandi Campbell reports from Naples.
In southwest Florida, in Naples, hurricane-force wind gusts are expected going into Wednesday as Hurricane Ian will pass the coast. The city is just south of the storm's predicted cone of uncertainty. We did speak with residents and visitors scoping out conditions ahead of the storm. The level of concern is mixed in the community.
Yesterday, we were very confident about it, and now realize it's such a big thing.
A little anxious, so we've got to get some nervous energy out of this and take a walk before we're shut in for a few days.
The city has taken several steps to prepare for the storm, closing facilities and parks early, even dropping stormwater storage lake levels. The airport in Naples also planning to close when winds pick up. In Naples, I'm Brandi Campbell for Fox Weather.
Civil rights lawyers and Democrat senators are pushing for legislation that would limit U.S. law enforcement agencies' ability to buy cell phone tracking tools to follow people's whereabouts, and sometimes without a search warrant. Concerns about police use of the tool known as Fog Reveal surfaced in a Federal Trade Commission hearing 3 weeks ago. Police agencies have been using the platform to search hundreds of billions of records gathered from 250 million mobile devices. There's been a lot of news coverage about crime in big cities. Talking about this on Today's Issues, author and radio host Frank Turek said the Defund the Police movement, as well as liberal prosecutors and district attorneys, contribute to the lawlessness in American cities. But they're not the only ones he blames.
It happens when the church has been silent for so many years. Obviously, when Don Wildman started AFA, Tim's dad, he knew there was a problem in our culture back in the 70s, and it obviously predated that too. It was way back in the 60s when the sort of lawlessness began, the rejection of the Judeo-Christian ethic, and the church has been silent for 50 or 60 years.
One city in Colorado is getting tougher on shoplifting. Fox's Jeff Manasso has the latest.
Get caught stealing more than $300 worth of merchandise in Aurora, Colorado. It's now an automatic 3 days in jail. Amid a wave of thefts there, council member Danielle Jurinski helped spearhead the shoplifter go to jail campaign.
I hope that we send a message that if you come to Aurora and steal anything, you will go to jail.
The ordinance passing by a 6-4 vote, with opponents saying that jail time isn't the best answer for thieves. Some businesses in Aurora report up to $50,000 in losses from theft. Losses in bigger businesses there top $1 million so far this year.
Mississippi Governor Tate Reeves is being blamed for Jackson's water problems. The Associated Press says that when he was the state treasurer, he had a hand in delaying funds for water system repairs. Jackson continues to have water system problems. Residents were recently left without running water for days. Reeves said recently that restoring water was a priority for his administration. A pharmaceutical company agrees to pay nearly $1 billion to settle allegations of pay-for-play with doctors. Fox's CJ Papa has more.
Biogen claims it did nothing wrong, but federal prosecutors say the company broke the law by paying kickbacks to doctors in the form of speakers and consulting fees to persuade them to prescribe its multiple sclerosis drugs from January of 2009 through March of 2014. The U.S. Attorney for Massachusetts says the agreement settles a whistleblower lawsuit brought by a former Biogen employee. Biogen will pay out more than $843 million to the feds, with the whistleblower picking up about $250 million of the federal dollars, according to the Justice Department, which adds another $56 million will be sent to 15 states for overbilling Medicare and Medicaid insurance. CJ Papa, Fox News.
In final news, a mixed bag on Wall Street. The Dow ended 125 points lower at the S&P 7. The NASDAQ is up 26. Find more news at AFN.net.
Yeah. I've got a longing to go when the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there.
Hello, neighbor. This is Brother Traber. Thank you for listening to KNBBC.com radio. I'd like to invite you to join me for Revival Time, our daily 15-minute radio broadcast. Tune in each weekday, 7 a.m. and 4 p.m. Pacific right here on KNVBC.com radio.
Thank you. Hello, this is Adam Rollins from South Glens Falls, New York, and you are listening to the best in Christian music, KNVBC.
Peace.